A10 Networks has identified over 22 million weapons worldwide. Once the DDoS attacks do not steal personal data, why do hackers and people insist in develop and create so much weapons of this kind?
Well, with DDoS attacks, we've seen them increase over the last few years. Some of them have got up to like 1.7 terabits per second. But the reason, or the motivation behind them, can be for many different reasons. For example, we've seen people do it to distract IT security teams so that other things can happen. There was a famous example in California where $900,000 was stolen from a bank website. And basically, the DDoS attack kept the security team distracted. We've also seen it for geopolitical reasons as well. So it can be for many different reasons, but the ultimate goal is to take the website or the resource offline.
Great. And how much of this weapons affect the Brazilian market, the websites, or the Latin America market?
Well, as you mentioned earlier, we've seen 22 million worldwide. In South America, we've seen over 800,000 potential reflectors or IoT drones, which could be used to attack corporate websites anywhere in the world.
Great. And how are companies dealing with the new technologies such as IoT and the new digital technologies? How are they dealing with them in order to get protected against these kind of weapons?
Yes, with the digital transformation which we're seeing worldwide, a lot more resources are going online. Our daily way of life relies on the internet, from banking to buying concert tickets, whatever it might be. So organizations really need to try and make sure that they protect these resources the consumers or their customers are accessing. So really it's about putting solutions in place which help with availability. So for example, DDoS protection, one of the big things about it is trying to automate the protection, especially with IT security teams being very stretched. So at A10, for example, we have our Thunder Threat Protection System where we automate the protection lifecycle. We can give lists of known bad actors and block those. You can download them daily, for example. We can also do machine baselining to make a custom protection profile for your particular network as well. So it makes it much easier to defend against it with a lot less knowledge.
Great. And are companies really looking at the security side of the business when we talk about digital transformation?
Some are, some are not. However, one thing we find is when people are actually under attack, then it becomes very important. Some companies are proactive and put in defenses ahead of time. Others do react when something happens, especially when they get complaints from their customers or their end users.
And talking a little bit about the security teams, when we talk about artificial intelligence, new technologies, digital transformation, what we see a lot are professionals worried about losing their jobs or needing to recycle their experiences. How does this evolution happen in the security professional area? How do people need to prepare themselves?
Well, I think people, obviously if something's bad happen, the IT department might be worried about their jobs in some circumstances. But those who are prepared and normally take those proactive steps, as I mentioned earlier, and make sure they have defenses in place, they also have the scale so that they can serve their end customers as well. But a lot of it really is around working smarter, not harder. So being able to use advanced analytics, leverage third-party resources, which know, for example, where the bad actors are, instead of trying to work it out themselves, because that can be an impossible task. Like, as we were talking about earlier, the 22 million weapons worldwide, an individual person in a small company as a security administrator wouldn't know about those. So leveraging third-party tools such as the A10 Thunder Threat Protection System, they can help themselves to keep their networks up and running.
And just a last question, still about the professional market. How does AT Networks look at the professional market? Do you have hard times finding security professionals, or are they available in the market? Are they prepared to get in the market? How do you see this availability?
Well, you know, the economies are booming worldwide, right? So, you know, unemployment, for example, in the US, where I'm from, is very high right now. So I think there's a shortage for every type of company. We have, for example, ourselves, our dedicated security team, which is fully staffed. But we also try and use automated methods to gather the information, because that's really the future. You basically want to be able to take reproducible systems to be able to extract data. So for example, with some of the data we talked about with the weapons earlier, we use honeypots around the internet to be able to identify those people who are uploading malicious code and the weapons they're using. And then we can then pass that on to our customers.